Aboitiz Construction completes the expansion initiative of Austal Philippine Shipbuilding Facility in Balamban, Cebu. Aboitiz Construction, Inc. is the construction arm of Aboitiz. Well, with us now for more for the briefing is Albert Ignacio Jr., Aboitiz Construction's President and Chief Operating Officer. Good to have you on the show, Albert. Welcome to the program.
Thank you, Kathy, and good morning.
So how significant is the expansion initiative on Austal Philippines, a shipbuilding facility? Because I understand that it is designed to accommodate the large vessel projects for hull assembly, for final outfitting and painting capacity.
Well, we've been contracted by Austal Philippines to build three bays. The main bay is the John Rothwell Assembly Bay. And as you mentioned, this is intended for the large vessels. It was inaugurated last July 24, and it allows them now to actually do the shipbuilding here in the Philippines for these large vessels.
And that means a lot of jobs. I mean, is there a growing demand for these types of vessels? I mean, not just for defense, but commercial. And which is the bigger driver for Aboitiz Construction these days? Is it defense or for commercial purposes?
Well, we don't have any engagement yet with Austal Philippines for the shipbuilding. We constructed the facilities, and on the day they inaugurated their facility, we signed a memorandum of agreement that in the event that they would win the bid for the defense of OPVs, then we would be doing the steel cutting and hull fabrication for them.
So this relationship, yes.
There's a relationship. We built the original facilities of Austal. We also did the expansion, which I mentioned earlier, was inaugurated last July. And we're hoping that aside from the shipbuilding work that we do for another Japanese company in that area, we would also be able to do it for Austal Philippines.
And what's the latest there on the new offshore patrol vessels, or the OPVs? Because I understand this will be used by the Armed Forces of the Philippines.
Well, it's a negotiation, or it's an arrangement. It's something that's being worked on by Austal Philippines and the Defense Department. And our involvement would be at the time if they win the bid for this. So I can't say much about the OPVs until it's actually awarded to Austal.
That's true. But what is your role going to be if Austal Philippines wins the bidding? Because you could be tapped for actually doing the same, just cutting as well as fabricating the steel mills. Is that correct?
Yes. We're helping Austal. We're actually giving Austal some price or budgetary estimates. And we're reviewing with them some drawings, some details, so that we can come up with a competitive price, specifically on the steel hull fabrication and cutting.
How competitive is the pricing? I mean, what have you put out?
Well, I think our price would be competitive. We are currently doing steel hull fabrication, as I mentioned, for a Japanese steel building company. But these are not OPVs, these are bulk carriers. And compared to the price overseas, I think it would be more competitive because our labor cost is much lower here.
Is it? I mean, what percentage, though? I mean, how much of a lower cost is that when you consider all the kinds of costs that come in to manufacturing and production? Like, for instance, power costs, one of the highest in Asia.
Hard to say as to what percentage, but easily, if you compare to the fabrication, where we bid for overseas fabrication. We do it also in Balamban in our modular fabrication yard. I would say that our prices are at least 10-15% lower. But it depends on the type of fabrication that we do. Because for the modular fabrication, we're very competitive. I'm not sure though for the steel hull fabrication for the OPVs. We don't know yet. We don't have the details.
Still in its early days, but I do know that you also manufacture the large high-speed passenger and vehicle passenger ferries. What is the level of demand for these?
Again, Kathy, that's an Austal contract, but I know that they have a very good order backlog for this type of vessels. In fact, during the inauguration, they've launched one for a French company. And a couple of months ago, I also them launching another ship for Hong Kong. So I understand there's a demand. They're also increasing their manpower requirement. But I'm not in a position to discuss about the hostile orders.
No worries, that's fine. But a final point here. Any other projects in the offing for the next year or two for Aboitiz Construction?
Well, we're bidding for a plant, a diesel plant. Unfortunately, because of our non-disclosure agreements, we cannot mention the name of the project or the location. But we're very busy now bidding for a cement plant, a desalination plant, and we're about to finish a power plant in Mindanao. Other than that, there's another one. We're about to complete a resin plant in Bataan.
All right.
Well, there's a lot of projects that we're looking into, but our main business actually is more on structural steel fabrication and erection, including pipe works. So we're not into the high-rise building projects.
But are these projects, all the projects that you want to bid for, all aligned with what you do in Aboitiz Construction and aligned with the BBB program of the government?
Well, for the PPP, the BBB, we are not directly involved. We're hoping to become a major subcontractor for the EPCs who will be bidding for these projects. But most of our projects are in the private sector, petrochemical plants, power plants, and industrial plants.
All right. Well, keep us up to speed on the expansion plans there and the projects that you bid and win. Thank you so much for joining us, Albert Ignacio Jr. of Aboitiz Construction.
Thank you.